This tutorial is going to take you through the process of customizing your Google site through aesthetic means. And the first thing we're going to do is to look at backgrounds and how to choose something from a Google Sites template, as well as how to customize and create your own. And we're going to look at creating and using a logo, which we can do with many programs. And I'm going to show you two and point you in the direction of a third. And then we're going to look at what are called CSS, cascading style sheets, which you don't actually have to do manually in Google Sites. You can do it by just using drop-down menus and to change your fonts, your colors, all sorts of really interesting things. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is to mess with a logo. And to get into your logo, you go to Options, and you go to Edit Site Layout. And you remember this from working with your navigation bars and everything like that. But in this case, you're going to go to the site header. And when we click on that, you can see that it brings up a few things here. It tells us our alignment. So do we want it to be vertically aligned somehow, horizontally? Do we want it to be centered, et cetera? And then do you choose a logo or do you not choose a logo? And how tall is it going to be? Is it going to be the size of the logo or is it going to be a certain number of pixels? And usually you're going to use logo size. But the problem is, of course, we don't have a logo. So I'm going to show you how to do this very, very briefly. My chosen ways to do this, I prefer to use Photoshop or to use Illustrator. I think that Photoshop is a little easier in many ways, but it's really personal preference. And so here I've got a bunch of a little more complex things than you certainly will use. But I want you to see that it's a bunch of layers. And so I've got a white layer here in the background, and then I've got these other pieces. So. Here's my little logo here from my Chinese stamp. Here is a different style of writing, and I decided I didn't want that, so I'm going to make that invisible. And then I've got the writing that I actually wanted here. And then I've got a white background. And what I wanted to show you is that the white background is here to test it, but it's really not what you actually want to use. You really want it to be a transparent background and then save it that way. But you'll see that that won't really be an issue. To make a logo, it's actually very simple. Depending on whether you have an image or you're taking an image from somewhere, etc. I'm just going to show you how to do basic things with Photoshop now. And I'm going to create a new file here. And you'll see that it asks me my size and everything. And so this is by pixels. I'm actually going to make a much larger piece than I might want. And I'm going to do it by inches. And so let's say I want it to be maybe 3 inches wide by, 1.5 inches high, something like that. So it's a rectangle at 300 DPI and then RGB color. And this is not what you'd use for print. You'd want to change this to CMYK for print, but I don't think you need to worry about that right now. And then make it a transparent background. And then you'll click on OK. And what that's going to do is it's going to create a shape here. And we actually don't have to use this whole shape. You can change it very easily. You can go to this crop tool. And if it's on something else, you can change it back to crop by clicking and holding. And you can always constrain how big you want it or how small you want it to be in the proportion that you actually want. And once you've chosen it, you can press enter to accept or escape to reject. So once this is done, I'm going to press escape again. And I'm going to click to my pointer tool. You can see that this is basically just a transparent box. And I can add a layer here. The layer is transparent. I want to leave this as a background layer. I can even double click on it to show you what it's going to be like, so that we can record this and remember what this is. And you can also make a background that's white or gray or gradient or whatever you want by going to the fill button, which is this paint bucket tool or a gradient to be what you think the website is going to look like. You can even insert the background in there if you want to. So I'm going to create a new layer by clicking on this little button here, and then I can fill this with whatever color I want to. Right now it's black. I can click on white, or if I click on the color here, I can choose whatever color I want, whatever the background of your piece is. Now note that when you're here, this actually tells you a code, which is a web color, B60,000. So this is what you would use if you wanted to actually make the background of your website this color, but you wanted to start in Photoshop. And you can choose only web colors if you want to be able to do things that are only accessible with the web, which is what I would recommend. So in this case, I'm not going to do that. I really just want to have a white background. So I'm gonna click on this default and switch it so that I've got the foreground's white, background's black, so it make it white. And again, I'm gonna actually make this invisible before I go through and do anything else with the file, but I wanted to give you a feedback, a little bit of a background here so you can see it. So I'm gonna click on my font tool, which is gonna be the basic thing you're gonna use, and you can choose whatever font you want here. Let's say I want Vivaldi, right? And I wanna just use my type my name. Now you can see that this is not seeming like it's typing anything, but it's really just white. So I'm gonna press Control A or Command A, and then I can change the color so that it's black. And you can see it's also way too big. So I'm gonna highlight everything, Control A again. And then I can either reduce it this way, or I can click and drag down to make it smaller. And you can see that that's the way, and you can see I misspelled my name. you can see that's the way I'm gonna just have my logo. And so let's say it's just like that. And that's a little big, so I'm gonna click out. So let's say I wanna crop this down, and I'm going to have my logo just be like that. And maybe I can add something else to it. So I'm gonna press enter. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now let's create a new layer. And I'm going to create this selection tool, and I'm just gonna select a piece of my my document here. And then I'm gonna fill that with another color just to give myself a little bit of an accent. So I'm gonna go to my colors again, and I'm gonna choose that same red that I liked before, or a different red. And I'm gonna go to my paint bucket tool, and I'm gonna fill it. So now I'm gonna click on my selection tool and just click out somewhere so I can see what it looks like. So I think that looks pretty good. Now the problem is that when you insert this in a website, this red is just gonna appear in this one little piece. So you have to choose whether or not you want that to only be there, or you want that to be throughout the document, in which case you need to create a background file for your document, which is a very different process that we're not gonna go into now. But this gives you some idea of how a logo should look. From here, what you need to do is to make this invisible so that it's transparent again. And I want you to go to File and Save As. And you can save this file, so keep it as a Photoshop file and name it whatever you want, like logo, etc. And then once this is done, you have a Photoshop file that you can go back through and edit, and that's great. But what you also need to do is Save for Web. And when you click on Save for Web, it's going to bring up a dialog box that looks like this. And here you can choose how big you want it to be. I would say don't choose any height that's larger than 100 pixels. That's about right for a logo. And make sure that the proportions are constrained with this little guy here so we can see what it actually looks like. So it's gonna be pretty small, but you'll see what it looks like. And make sure that you keep transparency here. And you can choose GIF, or you can choose PNG, or whatever you want. I would say GIF or PNG 24. Would be the best way to go, or 8, either one would be the best way to go here. I think GIF is fine for me, 256 colors, all of this is okay. So I can save this, and this will save the file that I will actually use for my document. I'll just go ahead and save this so you can see it. And so I'm gonna go to my my OneDrive here. Oops, I'm gonna go to save and my OneDrive, which of course it's gonna look completely different for you. And I'm gonna save this as test logo, just so I know what it is. Okay, so when that's done, we're good to go. You can also, and then I'm gonna close Photoshop here. So when this is done, you can also go through and do this in different files. So if you don't want to buy Photoshop, obviously, or use it in the computer lab, you can use Microsoft Paint, which is included with the program with Microsoft Windows. And you can see here when you make this new file, you can actually go through and choose some things about it. So I'm going to go ahead and make a new one. And you can see here I can resize it, and the size of it is down here, so I can make this my 100 pixels high if I want to, and however long I want it to be. You can see it's just nowhere near as exact, but it does give us what we want. And so then we can go through and add in text or whatever we want, right? So once this is done, you want to keep it on transparent, so transparent background. Although you can also add colors or etc., right? And you can add in shapes or whatever you want. So we can, you know, fill with a color. You can select an area. Basically the same exact thing. And then you would go through and save it as, and you can do again a PNG or a GIF file, whatever you want to do. So that's one program that you can use. And you can also use different kind of paint alternatives for Mac. And one of these is Paintbrush, and that works pretty well, and it's basically the exact same thing. But this website and many others give you a whole bunch of options to use. So once that's done, and you go back into your website, you have to be able to choose a logo. So I'm going to choose logo size for my height, and I'm going to do custom logo, and then I'm going to put in a file. And here, I'm going to choose, I can choose my test logo, or I can choose my other one here. And I'm going to upload that. And then it should give you a little bit of a preview here of what you're going to be doing. So that looks fine to me, and I'm going to click OK. And then once that's down, and you can see, this is way, way too big. This is really not what I wanted. So you can see that in here, I didn't have this saved with the right size. So then, of course, you can go down and constrain it if you want to. But you'll see that what it does in that case is it doesn't really mess with this logo because the logo is the wrong size, right? So what I have to do is go back and choose the right file here. So I'm going to click on Choose File. Then I'm going to go down here and click on the right one, right? This is the small one. So it'll take a second. It'll upload it, and you'll see that it's not actually going to change what I see here because it's going to it's the same exact file. It's just smaller. So when I click OK, it's going to make it much, much smaller. And then here, OK, we have much, much more detail in terms of what we want. So that's pretty much all you need to know for the logo. And so the first thing you notice, of course, is that we still have this site name up here, which is really unattractive. So this is where we start getting into more fun customizations. And so what we're gonna do here is click here and go to Manage Site. And here's where we have a gazillion interesting things. The first thing I wanna do is to take off this Show Site Name at Top of Pages thing. So when I unclick that and click Save, that's actually going to remove that from the site. So I'm gonna click Cancel. After it's saved, you can click Cancel to escape it. And you can see that that's gone. And all I've got is my logo, which is pretty much what I want. But there's a whole bunch of other things in the Manage Site piece that you should also look at. One is that you should do a site description, so you should talk about what's actually going to be there. You can choose what landing page people go to, in other words, what's the first site they see. There's all sorts of things that you can do in this piece. You can also do automatically adjust size to mobile phones, which I would absolutely recommend doing. And then there's all sorts of other things that you can do here. So users who can access site activity, I would say collaborators only, and users who can access revision history should be collaborators only. So once that's done, I would save it. And then you can go through and think about other sorts of interesting pieces that you can do here. Of course, you can add pages and you can move pages around and all of that kind of stuff. We're not going to mess with that. We want to do is go to themes, colors, and fonts. And you know that, of course, you can choose a theme at any time. And many of you have already done this, but you can choose different themes, and this will change all sorts of stuff in your piece. We're not going to mess with that right now. I just wanted to let you know that it is there. If you wanted to choose branches, for instance, that would immediately change everything to this template. But we're going to just do the blank slate, if I can find it again. And I want to show you how you can do some really simple things. And there's a couple of things that you might want to think about here. The first thing to think about is whether you want this to be centered or whether you want it to be on the edge and always expand when you make the site bigger or smaller. So right now I want to show you how it looks as it is. So I'm going to go back to cancel. And if I make this smaller, you can see that nothing really changes. And if there's, it always stays at the left, and it'll shrink it in really, really tightly. And that's one way to go, but I would actually recommend making it a more custom size. And what I would recommend usually is 1024 width, or a percentage of your screen width. And I prefer the 1024 pixels for a variety of reasons, because it's a standard size. So I'm going to go to Edit Site Layout again. And you can see here that we can do a custom and do a percentage or pixels. So in here, I'm going to do 1024. And then that's done. So I can click out and click on close. Oops, didn't work. Then 24 pixels. And you can see that it immediately changes this to be a centered piece. And so when this is closed, you can see that now when it's smaller, you can see it still stays, but when I make it bigger, it actually expands out. And that's gonna be really important when you have content and colors in this piece. So let's go through and start messing with the colors, and you can see what I mean. So the first thing we can do is think about the entire page. So you can do a theme for your background. You can do no color background. You can choose a color itself. So you can do, I don't know, a bright red, which is obviously not what you wanna do. You can also do an image, and this is where you can find some really, really cool images. So if you actually look for website backgrounds, you can find a whole bunch of really, really cool textures. So this Subtle Patterns Photoshop plugin thing gives you some interesting ones that you can mess with, and you can download these. But there's also a gazillion others that you can use when you look for website backgrounds. All sorts of really, really interesting things that then, of course, you could edit in Photoshop and see what you want them to look like. And what happens is many of these will repeat in space. If they look like this, for instance, this will repeat over and over again, because that's just the way they go. But you can see these that have a gradient, it's just going to look a little weird. So what you would do is you would shape the size by the width of this piece, so the 670. So that gives you some idea of what you'd want to do with backgrounds. In this case, you would just probably have it repeat, but you can see this is a 1920 by 1200, so the width is 1920 pixels, which is the width you would probably make the site, or you would just allow this to sit, and if you get any bigger than 1920, then it doesn't make a difference. So there's all sorts of things that you can do there in terms of backgrounds. And what's important to recognize is that you can do this over and over again in different places. So that image would work really well here for a big background, but you can also edit it and have a background in your site header, this top part, in the content, meaning down here, and you can choose it different for your headers and your backgrounds, right? Your gadgets that you've inserted in your content area. Your horizontal navigation, you can choose different backgrounds. So let's say when you have a background, let's make this a color. So let's say normally it will be, I don't know, what's a good color here? Let's say normally it will be a gray background, and let's say on hover it will be a lighter gray or something like that, and then our text will make this to be the color of white, and so you know that you can change your hover color. So let's make the hover color be a slightly different color. So let's hover it and make it a red or something like that, and that gives you some kind of perspective of how you want this to look. And you can choose your alignments, your layouts, etc. But I wanted to give you a feel for the ability to make some really interesting differences. So let's say my entire page is going to have a background of a very light gray, and then my header is going to have a background that is a slightly darker gray, something like that. And then I could have my content area have a background that, let's choose the same gray. And you can see that it's a little bit smaller here because there's a border here. And you can change the page title, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. There's all sorts of things that you can do to customize your site. So let's see how this looks, just to give you a feel for it. So I'm gonna click on save, and then I'm gonna go to cancel. And you can see here, I've got my selected piece, which is white, with white text, which is not what I want. And then when I roll over this, it gives me my my pink rollover, it changes the color, and it changes the copy. So I can go back into Manage Site, and I can look at where those white colors came in and why and all of that. And so that's really what you want to do, is really think about how you want to manage your colors and everything like that. So horizontal navigation, I know. Okay, so drop down, I know I need that to be a white copy, the same. Background color, I wanted to be that that light gray. Hover color, I want to be the I don't know, let's say a darker gray. I don't remember what they were before. Hover background color, etc., etc. So then when we go to our text and selected text, you can see selected text, text color needs to be white, and background color needs to be this gray, let's say. So you can see that's changed it already. So that gives you, and you can see that's a little bit too light of a gray, so maybe we want to go a little darker, something like that. But that gives you an idea of how this is actually going to look, and how easy it is to make things custom and make them look really good. Now, one thing I want to mention here is that this logo doesn't work at all with this gray, and that's because there's little white pieces all the way around, because I use some really kind of weird effects here. So this is why you use a transparent background. And so since I scanned this in and didn't modify it too much, there's some issues there. So I'd want to go back through and go back to my themes, colors, and fonts, go to my header, and then I want to change this to be a white background. So I can save it, and then I'm back to my site. You can see that looks a lot better. And when I change the size, you can see all of that kind of condenses in until it gets too big, and then it stays in the center. So if I had a really big monitor like this one, it stays in the center of the piece. So that's really the basics of making a really nice looking site, but based in your own desires of what you want it to look like, rather than what they're giving you as a basic template. Now, of course, you can choose one of the basic templates, and then you would just go through and modify to make it custom for whatever you want it to look like, to make it brand congruent, brand consistent. So good luck. I hope this was helpful.